The Hall of Famer David Aldridge doing the sideline work. Hennessy, never stop, never settle. And you see the third quarter numbers. That's when the Clippers put this game away.
How did we say the best center in basketball is can't play?
No. I'm glad
he's not the best center in basketball. Stop that.
Who is?
Stop that. He's not the best center in basketball.
Yes, he is the best.
If the man don't get no his own post moves, he can't be the best center in basketball.
DeAndre Jordan
is not the best center in basketball. He's up there.
You look at Anthony Davis, Karl Anthony Towns,
DeMarcus Cousins.
Keep going.
I don't count them. I'm talking about it makes the most impact.
Oscar. DeAndre Jordan makes the most impact of any back big guy.
DeMarcus Cousins are better players.
I love hearing what you guys have to say, but I really think we need two more voices added to the conversation.
Cat is better player.
Let's go to Area 21.
If he's a better player, then how can he be the best? So you ain't making no sense. Hey, you sound like an idiot.
I think Cat is a four to me.
We've got guests.
KG.
KG and
Shea. DeAndre Jordan the best center in the league right now? Yes or no?
I wouldn't say that, but I would
Thank
agree.
Thank you.
I would agree with the effectiveness of for the Clippers and what he does for the Clippers. He's really effective, but he's not the best center.
Thank you, KG.
Who is the best center?
I think it's a toss now between Boogie and Anthony Davis.
Yeah.
You know, they're the fives. You know, I think Karl Anthony Towns plays to four.
He's coming along.
Comes in at five, but he's too young right now. It comes with, you know, guys being over 4 and 5 years, established themselves, Boogie and Anthony Davis.
See, I still look at AD as a four. So it was really between he and Cousins to me. Cousins is a better player overall, but the impact that he makes with the Clippers is just
when you're the best, bigger. You're the best. You can't say he's the best and say somebody's better.
Yeah, but sometimes you're
you ain't making no sense.
Yeah, no.
Is the man the best or not? No, he's not the best.
Because I don't know if he's a looter in a riot. I don't know if he's getting these big numbers because he's on a bad team. Mm. Until his team shows that they're a good team and he's putting up those numbers, a la James Harden, a la Russell Westbrook, and they're getting wins,
When it comes to the best, you're talking about singular. We're talking about
DeAndre
Jordan's the best center in the game.
No, he's not.
All right.
No, he's not.
I wouldn't say that, but he's very effective.
Yeah, he's effective.
No, but I'm not counting AD and Cat.
He does what he do for them.
And he's great at it. He's a great. He's probably the best defensive big in our game.
If he was on Milwaukee, would he be the best in the game? Thank you.
Milwaukee would be a lot better than DeAndre Jordan.
KG, I got a question along these lines. Didn't you? You did some work with the Clipper bigs, did you not?
I did. I had the opportunity to go down and work with a couple of their bigs, and it was refreshing. You know. The one thing I think about when I'm working with young guys is their work ethic. And coming in, working with Blake Griffin, coming in, working with DeAndre Jordan, Brandon Bass, a lot of those guys, it was refreshing. It was refreshing to come in, and a lot of the stuff I was teaching them or showing them perspective, he was getting right away, which was refreshing to me, man. It's good to know the bigs. You know, for some reason, I don't know why they're trying to oust the bigs in this game, but.
Yeah.
You know, the bigs are very, very big part of our game.
Well, just for the record, KG, it's no big deal to score no 40-year-old man.
Say what? Hey, I thought you were asleep.
It's no big deal. They butted
Hey, he's hit the cusp
button. It's scoring on a 40-year-old man. You're 40 years old. Anybody can score on you.
Hey, you bring your ass in here, see if you can score on me. That's what you do.
Hey, Rashid, I want to talk about the
nah,
new era.
Nah, forget all that, Kenny. Tell him. No. Get in the car. Come over here to Area 21 and get a
bucket. You don't want none of that, KG.
Yeah, you don't want none
of that. Sleep, man. That man sleep.
You don't want
that.
That's why I kept it moving, man. I kept it moving.
I
see you happening.
No, I had to ask Sheed about the ability of what the fours and fives do now, and basically what you were able to do when you were a player, your ability to stretch three and post up.
Right.
Like.
Right.
Where is the guy that's that Rasheed Wallace that has the ability to do both, kind of post up and shoot the three?
Well, you have a few guys in the league like that now. But for me, when I did it, it was to stretch my career. You know, it was coming towards the end of my career. And, you know, you can't bump and grind down there like R. Kelly every night. So you got to go ahead and take a couple pillow nights, you know. Go ahead out there to the three and just stretch it. And it helped me. You know, I learned it from Cliff Robinson, actually. Right. So it helped me, but now a lot of the younger guys that's coming into the game, they just automatically coming in and you know, popping that three or whatever. But it's a few guys out there who do like to post. Not too many, but
yeah, I can't think of them either.
Man, shoot that. You think the big shoot the three too much these days?
Yes, they do.
Yeah. Yeah, they do.
Bigs,
they do.
Right. I would like to see the bigs get back into the paint, be like Diesel, be like real bigs.
Real
and
bigs.
I saw a stat that the bigs are shooting.
Oh, everybody's
better,
shooting threes now, too.
No, shooting better than the perimeter players. If you take the fours and five 3-point percentage, it was actually better than the one, twos, and threes.
Yeah, but I think
these guys are as many too.
Right. I think these guys contested. Are fell in love with the three, and they're shooting too many threes. Right.
Way too many.
Yeah, true. Right. True
and,
that,
and,
Chuck.
All of them, the one, two, right. three, four, and five are shooting too many threes.
Yeah.
And the level of basketball to me is going down. We saw a team shoot 90 threes tonight, and these are two good offensive teams. That's too many threes in a game.
Hey, last thing, KG, before we let you and Sheed go.
Right. You chuck the bed.
So it's 2:35 here in the East.
Right.
How you liking this TV gig?
It's cool, man. You know, we're night owls anyway.
This,
you know,
this is our time.
This is when we wake up. This is when we handle our business. I'm like, true. Chuck, you know, it's probably 2 hours past Chuck's. He looked like he in his pajamas already. So, you know, hey, Chuck, come over and get a bucket. Right?
Hey, listen, it is late for me. I ain't gonna lie.
It is. Oh yeah, it is.
2:35 in the morning.
No, no, no.
The double overtime is killing me.
Hey, if there was a beat and a beer, he would be up though.
Right, right, right.
He would have a whole different persona.
Don't forget the blackjack.
Hey. All right. Oh, yeah. I know you don't go to sleep in Vegas.
Yeah, that liquid oxygen they pumping in there.
Let's see that tweet you got up there, Jeremy. Let's see what you got.
Oh man.
Find a trash and lean and
Oh, get him off you, Rashid.
Come on, man.
Get him off you, Rashid.
You know what I mean? I ain't all that dress up. You know what I mean? That's me.
Right.
I got an
Right.
Just laid back.
Right.
Yeah, y'all seen it when I was playing. I wasn't all trying to get suited up. This cat killed me one day. We was in the playoffs and I got suited up. you remember when you got off the bus first and you was like, y'all take this camera.
Pull it up.
Take this camera and look at this next guy getting off of this bus. You'll never see it again.
Oh, yeah, I did see that.
And who?
All right, KG, Sheet, thanks a lot.
I can read lips. That's what's funny. Yeah, we're going to get in the bag.
Yeah.